Happy morning, children. How are you all? We had a Zoom session yesterday and where we have discussed many things, how you are supposed to prepare for your exams. And I have given you some suggestion how to read your text. Try to follow all these things, children. The instruction which the teacher gives you, it is going to benefit you. So don't skip any Zoom meeting which is planned by the teacher. And moreover, you are going to have your term 1 examination very soon. I am not satisfied with your PA2 performance. Why I am telling this, that I am not satisfied with your performance, is when I got your PA1 marks, I was expecting that my students will score more than PA1 in PA2 exams, but your marks was not like that. So I got disappointed. Term 1 examination, you have to get good marks. Prepare well. Welcome to the session, children. Yes, to start with today's session, I have some questions for you. Look at the image which is given for you. And now I'll have a question. Do you have a good memory? Do you people have a good memory, children? Do you have a good memory? Or you are known for forgetfulness? As a youngster and as a kids of adolescence period, you should have a good memory. And here I would like to add one more point. If you are going to spend your time in playing games in mobile, it will lead to memory loss. Your concentration will scatter. If you feel like you don't have a good memory, then it is because of your mobile phone where you play games. Stop doing that. When you get aged, like when you turn 35 or 40, you can feel that you have a bad memory. But at this age, if you don't have a good memory, it is because of your concentration in mobile phones. Many psychologists and many psychiatrists, they'll say, like, young children, if they are going to utilize the technical gadgets, it will just kill their memory. It will just make them lose their concentration. A scientific study has proved it. So now answer my question. Do you have a good memory? Or come to the next question now. Has your memory ever played any tricks on you? Can you get this question? Has your memory ever played any tricks on you? Where your parents will ask you to do something and you will forget. It has to be done on that particular time. If you miss to do that, you will worry for that. Do you have such feeling, or have you come across any experience in your life? Next question. See here, see this image. Because of memory loss, we will say like this. Shit, I forget to do it. Okay. Same picture. And a girl who is worried because of forgetting something. So all these pictures gives you an idea. People will worry about their forgetfulness. They'll forget things and they'll worry about it. So the next question is, you can see here, forgetfulness often puts you in a tight spot. Have you realized such situation in your life? Forgetfulness often puts you in a tight spot. Yes, when your teacher tells you something and you forget to do that, and it will be some important work, you'll be in a tight spot over there. Or when your parent asks you to do something and if you forget that, again, you'll be put in a tight spot. What is called tight spot, children? It is a difficult situation. You can't overcome that situation. You don't have any answers with you. So, if you have that forgetfulness, it will put you in a tight spot, in a difficult situation. And here, one more thing, but forgetting a part of your life completely may drive you crazy. Look at the thing, children. Forgetting a part of your life. We know that some patients, because of their sickness, they get into a stage of coma, and again when they come back to their life, they forget part of their life. And some people who met with an accident, who get injured in their forehead or midhead like this, they will lose their memory. They don't know what happened in their life. There is a famous Tamil film. Okay, you would have watched it even. I don't want to share the name of that film, which talks about memory loss. There are many movies, but when you see a movie based on memory loss, when you find that an actor forgets a part of his life, he could not recollect things. But forgetting a part of your life completely may drive you crazy. Crazy means full of confusion. You don't know what to do. So, the lesson which we are going to see today, it is based on this concept. You can find that forgetting a part of life happens in the character. Where it happens? It happens in a character. The main character of the story. Shall we get into the lesson now? What is the next lesson? Is there any idea? Yes, Bipin Chowdhury's memory loss. That is the next lesson. Before going into the lesson, let me introduce the writer of the story. The writer of the story is Satyajit Ray. Come on, tell his name with me. Who is the writer of the story? It is Satyajit Ray. You can call him as our own Satyajit Ray. Why we can call him as our own Satyajit Ray? Because he is a writer and he is an Indian. He is an Indian writer. He is an Indian writer and he has achieved something in his life. What is that? Come on, let us see one by one. Indian filmmaker, and he is an Academy Award winner of Lifetime Achievement. Okay, he was the person who won Academy Award for Lifetime Achievement. What is his name? Satyajit Ray. So this person, he has written a lesson for you, a story for you, Bipin Chowdhury's memory loss. Indian filmmaker Satyajit Ray, and he is a Lifetime Achievement winner. He has written short stories for children and adults. Now, do you feel like seeing his image? Do you want to see who is Satyajit Ray? Yes, I'll show you the picture of Satyajit Ray. He is Satyajit Ray. You can find him. Great writer. An Academy winner of Lifetime Achievement. See, Lifetime Achievement winning, it is something noble. And to add up, you can find that this great man has done many films in Bengali. He has done many films in Bengali, and greatest filmmakers of 20th century. He is a publisher, calligrapher, and music composer. He is a music composer, calligrapher, music composer. And you can find that he is a graphic designer. Finally, he is a film critic. You can call him as a versatile personality. Have you come across a word called versatile? Do you have that versatility in you? This man, Satyajit Ray, he is a director of film. He has made greatest film of 20th century. He is a publisher, calligrapher, music composer, graphic designer and film critic. See the professions. So he is a versatile personality who is an all-rounder. I'll show you some of his images as a director, calligrapher and as a writer. So this great personality has contributed a lesson in your book. Don't you think that the lesson will be interesting then? Yes, it is going to be an interesting story. But you have to read the text. It goes for four parts. You have to read the text. I am going to explain you part by part. We'll do it. But it is your work. If you are interested, you can go ahead. Interesting story about a character called Bepin Chowdhury's lapse of memory. Who is the main character of the story? It is Bepin Chowdhury. And we are going to see about his lapse of memory. What is called lapse of memory, children? It is nothing but memory loss. Have your textbook in hand, underline it and write it off. Lapse of memory is memory loss. Bepin Chowdhury's memory loss. So Bepin Chowdhury is the main character in the story. Shall we start the lesson? Yes. This story has an element of suspense at the end. What does the story have? This story has an element of suspense at the end. Why I am telling you that this story is going to have an element of suspense at the end? Because it has a good twist at the end. And the element of suspense which is present at the end, it is going to be like a thriller over there. And it will give you an amazing experience when you read the story. Have you read thriller stories? Have you read the stories which have a suspense end? The same kind of story is this. In this story, Bepin Babu goes nearly crazy because he cannot recollect his stay at Ranchi. As I told you, Bepin Chowdhury is the main character of the story. He is also called as Bepin Babu. How is he called as? He is called as Bepin Babu. Bepin Chowdhury is also called as Bepin Babu. Don't confuse children. And you could find that this man Bepin Babu goes nearly crazy because he cannot recollect things. Okay, he lost his memory. He has lapse of memory. He has forgetfulness. And he forgets things. Okay, shall we see the main character now? Okay. So every morning, we'll start reading the story now. Come on, read with me. Every morning on his way back from work, Bepin Chowdhury would drop in Kali Charan in New Market to buy books, crime stories, ghost stories and thrillers. Just imagine this man as Bepin Chowdhury. He is also called as Bepin Babu. Bepin Chowdhury or Bepin Babu. Every morning on his way back from work, he will spend time in Kali Charan's new market. What he will do? He'll stop in Kali Charan's new market. It is nothing but bookshop, where he will get books like crime stories, ghost stories, and thrillers. From this you could know that he is a good reader of books. Who is this man, children? He is Bepin Chowdhury. Every evening, okay, when he returns, or every morning on his way back from work, you may think like he'll be doing some work by the night time. So this man Bepin Chowdhury will buy some books, crime stories, ghost stories and thrilling stories. Read the story with me, children. I'll explain you.